Hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three. Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look, and you'll see into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in the world of my creation. What we'll see will defy explanation. If you want to view paradise, simply look around and view it. Anything you want to do it, want to change the world, there's nothing to it. There's no life I know to compare with pure imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to be.
Okay, guys, we're back again for week number two, and we're going to do the tulips today. You can pick any colors you want for the tulips. You can use the colors that I did. I'm going to put some colors on my palette. I'll put my palette around here so you can see. This is the palette from the green, and I'm going to keep this because we'll have all the green petals and stuff we'll be putting on. So if you've got any purples, yellows, pinks, reds, any colors you can think of, you can see all the colors here I've put out for me to use, that you would like to put on your tulip. Just put them in your palette. I'm using orangish red, reds, purple, a reddish purple, and pink, yellow. I'm going to use all these colors. It's your painting, so do whatever you want to make it yours. You want it to be just like you would like. So there's all the different colors we can make for all of our tulips. We can make them any color we want now, see? All right, I'll put this back over here for my old left hand. And I'll start over here. I'll start here and work my way this way, I think. Oh, it doesn't really matter. I'll do this way and work over. It'll probably be easier to see. I'm going to take a... this size of filbert, I think. This, I don't know what size that is. It's not really, there's smaller ones than this. This one or that one, either one of these would work. I like a filbert because I like the way it'll fit the petals and stuff. You're going to paint your petals the way they grow. In other words, they don't grow back and forth this way, so you want your brush to come from the top to the bottom or the bottom to the top, because then you want your strokes to be that way. We'll make this one a... up there it was purple, but we don't have to do that. Let's make it red. So we'll start with the bright red. And start with the first petal and put a coat on it. This might take more than one coat, and I might even have to put some white with it because of that green. See, I'm coming around, making the petal grow up and down is how it grows. Now, you can see the fence through there. See, we're going to let that dry, but I think we'll have to do something about that. We're going to take a darker red, and if you wanted to make it a darker red, you could put a little bit of the purple that you have on your palette or a little bit of the blue, because it's going to be darker at the bottom, the color is, and blend itself out to the top to be lighter. So see how I'm kind of just stroking it lightly there? I think I'm going to have to wait till that dries a minute and put some white with it and cover it and go. It's going to have a second coat for sure. But let's see how this does. This is the red color. And I'll do the same on this side. And I'll stick with the darker color. These back petals are looking at the inside of the petals. They probably would look darker. You want that to dry. I'm lightening this with a little bit of white. Coming it down to the darker. And same as this one. I'll turn the... And I'll put this one here. I'll get one of my small round brushes. So I can get the edges a little bit better. Because it's kind of rough here by this side. I'm putting a little bit of white with the bright red. If you put yellow with it, it would be orange, so you don't want to do that. Putting a lighter at the top of this petal. Pulling it down. I'm going to stick my brush in just the red near the edge here. There. And I'll take the red. Lighter shade again for up here, the front petal. And go that little side one with the white and the red on the top. See how it's starting to take shape there? We'll take a little of the darker color. And again, you can make this dark color if you don't have a darker red. Just put some purple with it or a dark blue. I'm getting in the between here, the shading this petal, because they kind of overlap. So this guy's overlapping this front one. And so I'm making it a little darker, so you can tell there's petals there. They gives them some separation and some depth. And I'll get in here and get some white, or some of that light, the red again, to make it lighter, and come down around the front petal. And we'll do the other side on this petal. And it's starting to separate a little bit there. It looks like it is.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Come around. Maybe a little bit on the top of the back ones, just a little, where the light's hitting it. Now we'll take it back to the, I'll just wipe this off. And I'm going to go back in the dark red. And remember I said you start at the bottom with the darker. He's got a seam closer to the edge. Bottom all the way across before I get to the, put more light at the top. Now, I'm going to switch to the bigger filbert, using my red with the white again. Looking pretty good. Now, I think we can also make these with white in them. I think we'll leave this one a solid one. If we decide to put white in it, we can come back. I think I'll leave him like he is for now. Yeah, it looks pretty good. Now I'm going to wash the brushes out and come down to here. We can make him purple or yellow, either one. Let's see what to do, what to do. Let's see, I'll make him a... make him yellow. I'm going to take some white and go ahead and fill this in here because yellow is a light color. This is the green background. So I'm just going to go ahead and fill that tulip in before I start with the colors. There. Now, I'll mix a little bit of white with a bright yellow, just like a primary yellow. I didn't put yellow ochre on here for some reason. I think I'll put some on here. Yellow ochre is that mustard color. It's got a lot of green in it, but it's... Come on. Paint, work with me. It's kind of hard to do with one hand sometimes. There you go. Just got to talk nice to it. All right. Now, I want that so I can put some of that at the bottom. Again, we'll paint this the same way we were painting that. The other guy up there, the red one, just a different color. You guys have probably painted tulips with me more than once, but some of you have never done it, so Maybe you'll learn then something. Let's see. We'll paint all the petals in first. And like I said, you can add more petals. I mean, more tulips than I put on here, or a little less. You could put some daffodils, I suppose, if you wanted, but I didn't do that. I like those. But this, when you know, these, I made these flowers kind of big, and I thought, I don't want to be too overpowering with just the big tulips and daffodils. So I thought I'd let the tulips be the star. They are like spring to me. So I think I'll take a little bit of orange. If you don't have orange, you can take red and yellow and make orange. Just make it right here on your palette. And I will come at the top of this and pull some orange down.
That's pretty.
I don't like that this brush I'm using for that. I'm going to get a different brush. It is going to be pretty, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this will be better. Mixing a little orange up myself. Because the orange I have, I don't like the... It's not quite orangey enough. I'm really keeping a light touch on this. Because you don't want to overblend it. You can turn the brush on its edge. Let me get some more. We'll go back and pull the yellow back into this, and it help. But it probably would be easier for y'all too if we let the yellow dry. Although this is working out just fine. Back at that, I'm going to wipe this off and stick it in the yellow, just the plain yellow, and pull it up. Put it on its edge when you get up where the orange is and streak it up in there. Need some more on the brush. Just put it on your edge of your, put it on the edge. This is the fat side, and this is the edge, the skinny side. We're doing the skinny side when we get up here where the orange is. Kind of pull it into that. And we'll do the same all the way around, and then we'll go back and put some more orange and bring it down to the yellow. Some off. You don't want to get too much on your brush. Notice I have not been dripping it in the water. Keeping the brush dirty again. It's kind of a dirty brush day. Now we're going to dip this back into the orange. I think I'll just in the brighter orange without yellow mixed to it and go across the top. lightly. Turn the brush on the edge. And remember, it has to... I'm using just the bright color of orange without yellow in it now. You can always add more of these as you start putting other flowers in if you decide you want more tulips. That mustardy color. Remember when I told you it's always darker at the bottom? So we can put that yellow ochre down there and pull it up a little bit. Put it in between these petals that back here that are behind the front guy. And then I'm going to put a little bit of white with the bright yellow. And go back. Add another coat of paint on this yellow. Just have to keep working the red into the orange into the yellow and the yellow into the orange is what I'm doing. Kind of like this. Here's the yellow and there's the orange. You're just kind of making them meld. You don't want to blend them too much because they're two different, you want it to look like it's two different colors. After that dries, I'm going to pour more yellow up there because I think it needs it. But it needs to dry some before I do that. So since we're waiting for this to dry, we'll move on to another flower and we'll come back to this guy. At least we got the shape in there. Have to have another coat. So now we will make us a, what should we make it? Pink? Or purple? Let's see. I think I'll make it a purple one. Maybe this reddish purple color. Nah, I think I'll make it dark. Again, let's do the front one first. It seems a little dry, so I'm sticking my brush in the water. This would be a pretty one. Lighten it. Now I have to go back to the little round brush here. So I can define the petals more. We'll bring this one like this. There. So I'll get my little round brush that I had. Here it is. And I'll make a lighter purple with the white and that dark purple that I'm using. Just kind of outline the petals. Now, if your brush gets too gunky, now wipe it off, because if it gets too gunky, it looks gunky on your painting. Don't want any gunky tulips. There. Looking good. Darker at the bottom. Maybe we'll put white at the bottom. Pull white up. So therefore it'll be darker at the top. It's wet. I'll dry it. Rinse this off. This is the little angle brush I'm using. Clean the brush off and dip it in the white. And pull it up. Put it across the bottom, following the petal. Across the bottom, following the front petal. And then just pull it up. Wiping the brush off. Pulling some of that purple down into it. And now get that dark again at the top. This narrow, I'm using a little round brush now, the little, small little, just round. I'm going to pull some of these up.
himself a bath.
He is. He's came in here to, I guess, to get himself all cleaned up for I don't know what for.
For his guest.
Oh, that's what it is. Yeah. He's decided he likes you, doesn't he?
Mm-hmm. He's trying to look handsome.
He is handsome.
That's right. He don't clean himself up. He hasn't left my side.
Mm-hmm. You won him over with that big cookie.
That's right. Cookies will win anybody over.
Especially a guy.
Yeah, exactly.
That doesn't look too bad.
That's good. And I'm doing a really close-up shot.
Huh?
It's really close-up, so.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Yikes. So I can't afford any mistakes.
Oh, yeah, you can.
Yikes. All right. Now, let's see. We'll leave that just a few more minutes. You can make your tulips all the same color if you wanted to. It wouldn't make any difference. You can do however you want. I'm just trying to make the petals look a little more defined. All right, now we're moving on. Let's see. This I'm going to let dry a little bit more before I put that other coat on it. What colors have we not used here? Pink. Let me try a pink one, I guess. Brush clean because they're the dark purple. I should put white on this right here. Go a little because of that green underneath it. We could also have put the tape on this for the tulips, but that would have been a lot of cutting out and trying to get it right. I didn't think it would be too hard to paint over the green for the tulips. Thinking of Pookie and tulips. There. Okay, we're painting this one up here pink, and I've put some white on. Like I said, I put some white on it because of the green background we're trying to cover. So that's where we are. So I'm going to go ahead and put white on these back petals. And then while this is drying, I'm going to see if the yellow is dry, and I'll go back and fix that one a second coat. And then we'll be, only have one more flower to do, one more tulip. Now those will be drying. And we'll come back to this guy here and put some white on our brush with some bright yellow. Yellow's a tough one because it's very translucent and it's hard to cover. But if you get two or three coats, you'll get it. So don't get discouraged. But you need to let it dry between coats. Otherwise, all you're doing is moving the paint around. This will do it. One more time in the front, and then we'll do some more of the orange top. I'm laying the brush kind of flat. You can see here's straight onto the canvas, laying it flat on the side, kind of getting these petals. And up here I'll do the same thing. One more little bit of yellow there, and then we'll go to the orange. There, now I'm gonna wipe the brush off on a rag or a paper towel and get in that orange color, the bright orange. I think I need to spritz my palette again. It seems like it almost like it gets a little crust on top of the acrylic. It's just starting to dry is what it is. There. Pull it down. The second coat does the trick, doesn't it? There. Edge, top edge, and then turning it on the skinny side and pulling it down. Light touch. Wipe your brush off if it gets too gunky, too thick of paint. It happens pretty fast. Looks pretty good. I do say so myself. Back to the pink one now. I'm going to wash this spangled brush out and clean it off. And dip it into the pink, because we already put white on there. And we'll put a coat of pink on it. Do all the petals in pink, and then we'll darken them. Or lighten them, whichever we think it needs. Maybe I'll lighten it. There's all kinds of tulips. There's so many different kinds that some have real pointy looking leaves, and I mean petals, and some are two-toned like these I put down here, and some are real wispy looking. I found pictures of some like that when I was looking, but I decided to just do the traditional kind everybody's familiar with. Every time. Okay, let's see. Maybe this right here with it. I put a little of that maroon color with this pink for the bottom to be a little dark. Kind of a maroonish color is what I call it. It's a reddish purple that I put on my palette. So I'm shading it myself with my head, my big head shading it.
I look down and I says, he's over there suckling on his little baby.
He does. He's a big baby.
He's very sweet once he lets you be.
Yeah, he is. Once that's what I said. His nature isn't to be. He's just protective of me.
Yeah. If you sit on the floor with him and give him a cookie, he'll
warm up to you.
Right, right, right.
What you looking for, Betty? He's gotten so used to me being home all the time, boy. When things ever get back to normal again and I start running around, he's going to be beside himself.
He's going to lock the door so he can't leave.
Mm-hmm. He's so used to whatever room I'm in, that's where he is. Needs this dry a little bit before we can get any more shading on it, I think. So we'll let that one be and come to this guy. Last color, what do we do? Guess we could just do another red and make it a real bright red. Make it a different color than the other one. You can always correct your mistakes with your brush after you've drawn something you don't like the way it looks. You can always change it, make it curve a little differently, or whatever you want to do. Put a little white on it when I'm going over this green because it'll cover it better. This will be a pretty one. I think we're going to put any more tulips on there. I think five of them is plenty for the size I drew them. But like I said, you can make as many as you want on yours. We're going to take a little bit of that reddish purple to shade with it. This on this one. Make it dark in there. Put that petal coming down that way. This one going that way. Wipe the brush off. Maybe I'll take yellow and just go across the top of this. Wipe it off again, dip it in the yellow. I'm using the skinny edge, just the edge of the brush. Dip it in the yellow again. Just going around the edges pretty much. I'll pull this down just a little, so the edge is a little less. Tip in the yellow again. Get it up in the edges of it, just so I have a little yellow here and there. Need to get some more yellow. Go around the edge. If it skips a little bit, that's okay. I don't want it to be everywhere. Again, make it darker in the center. There, put this edge of this down there. Wipe the brush off, put a little bright red on it. Put some greens down there. Give this petal a little more definition. There. dry because you can see the green through there, I think. We can fix that even later on once this dries. Okay, so now we're going to do some... Put the stems on there. We need to go back to that guy too, but let's go ahead and put some stems on. I'm going to use this small angle brush and just any of the greens you like, just a bright green. Or the tulips have a little, they kind of a wide base here before the stem goes, and it kind of goes up on the flower a little bit. And then just take the brush to the thin side and pull it down. You'll have to make it thicker, which is easy enough. You just can put it, press, the harder you press, the thicker your stem will be. That looks about the right size stem for this guy, I think. And you'll have to put some underneath the flower and attach it to the stem. And there's the first one. And the second one, we'll have to see, put it wherever we want to also. Let's see, we'll make it just kind of go this way, I guess. Some highlights to it. This guy is over this way. Two more here. And then this guy can come this way. Makes them look more like tulips now, doesn't it?
Yeah.
They're getting... Like I said, you press down. Once you get the direction, you know where they're going, you can press down, make a thicker stem. I need to get a little more water on my brushes. The paints are getting kind of thick. Sometimes they are thick like that. Just have to thin them down with water. Now we'll go back over to the first guy and put maybe a little bit of this lime color, bright green. Well, down the side the light's coming. We're saying the light's coming this way, so it would be lighter on this side of the stem. Not really a whole lot, because there's going to be so many other leaves and things, but just a streaky looking edge. On each one. Busy day.
Popular today.
I am. Half of them are those sales people. Like, they sell me up, try to sell everything. And I've gotten every scam call there is. I still can wait and do this guy when he dries a little more. So we can go ahead and start making leaves and things. You can use your angle brush as a good start. And if you want to, you can use start off with a bigger angle brush and then move into a smaller one, or you can use a round, you can use a fan, you can use all kinds of things down in here. So I'm going to use the big guy that I use for the fence and dip it in a couple of the greens. I'm going to dip it in the sap green and that light color kind of. And this is, again, you just don't give a whole lot of thought to it. Just start at the bottom and pull your way up to a leaf. Just like that. Don't make a whole lot of trouble. If you sit there and just work every leaf at a time, it's going to look real stiff and like that's what you did. So use all these greens that we used in the backgrounds and all that, and just go ahead and put some in. See, you don't have to. We'll go in and add a vein to it, or a hot light side or something like that as we come along. But you can see by the one that we did, it's just done real loose. They cross each other. And we'll use smaller brushes as we go along also. Just go make different where you let it look streaky like, because there's a lot of different colors in leaves. Just press it down and pull it up and lift it off. It's easy, isn't enough, isn't it? That's what we do. But don't put a whole lot of worry to it, because you'll make yourself crazy. And don't try to do it exactly like they're on mine, because I can't do that either. This is going to look entirely different than that one we did as a sample. Now you just keep on. You can go ahead and add a few lighter shades to some of these. Or darker, however you want to do. And keep using a thick brush. You can go to a smaller brush. I will be going to a smaller brush here. Darker shades, kind of make them darker down below. We got a lot of flowers to put in here too, but we can put those right out even if the leaves are in the way. I'll move to a smaller brush now. Just a smaller angle type brush. Kind of work on these a little bit before I add any more. Get the points, the tips of them a little more defined. And there's some of them look real ratty, so we'll straighten those up. I'm just trying to study here to see where all... Here's another one that's kind of ratty. Kind of get it a little more cleaned up looking. Not like something's gnawed on it. Okay, let's see. How's our time, producer?
10 more minutes.
Okay.
And then we'll go into session 3.
Mm-hmm. So we're going to finish that pink flower. I think we have enough of these leaves on for this session. We'll go back further because we've got other things to put in and other flowers, other leaves. Let's see here. Okay, I'll wipe that brush off because I don't want to get all dried on the brush, and then go back to our tulip, our pink tulip. Darker pink. Clean off my brush. It's too gunky. Remember when you're painting, you really only need to put paint right on the tips of your brush, not up here. When it's all gummed up here and gets up by the metal, then you're just going to never be able to get a decent stroke because you've got too much paint on there. Lighten it up a little bit in spots. That helps. There's Starting to get a big petal. For the sake of repeating myself, I don't see the need to tell you how to do each tulip because I've told you guys that. Probably get tired of hearing me talk. It's kind of nice to hear the quiet. I'm taking blue white and mixing with the pink too because I'm trying to get another shade in there. And the white will make it a lighter pink. Again, I'm using a small angle to do this. You could use a filbert or a flat if you wanted, or even a round. You gotta find the brushes that you like. I can tell you what they're for. That doesn't mean you have to use every brush I use. If you don't like the one you're using, pick something else out of your menagerie there laying beside this. And see what you like better, because that's what you have to do is find your little niche. Filberts are my favorite. They're kind of the. I like the angle brushes too, though. I never used to, but I do like them. Bumps on this. Canvas or something right there. Okay, that's what's bugging me, I guess. Just will have to be a gnarly tulip. Starting to see petals. There. Put some of the darker at the bottom. That'll work. Straighten up this red one. And I think it'll be time to close shop. I'm going to make this fatter because I can. I just think it needs to be fatter right here. I think that looks better. Okay. I think that'll about do it for number two, do you think? And we'll be back for number three next week. So catch up with me.
I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places that this heart of mine embraces all day through. In the small cafe, the park across the way, the children's carousel, the chestnut trees, the wishing well, and I'll be seeing